The American elections, I had the feeling that the American dream was a psychosomatic condition.
Really? Excuse me.
Induced by Don, a mixture,
you know,
of a
John
mistaken
Wilder
interpretation
to put in an appearance.
Of history.
I think he might
and
do,
too
yes.
Much
make sure I get a word with him, would you?
Did you know that the Big Dipper at Coney Island is so big that when you get your ticket, they sell you travel sickness pills?
Whistle at it.
Whistle?
Yes, like the lady said. You know how to whistle, don't you?
I saw the film. Whistle what?
Anything.
Were any of those interpreters I sent over to you any good?
No.
Oh, well, I'm sorry about that.
Well, it doesn't matter.
Perhaps if I knew what you wanted an interpreter for.
Principally to go with me to the common market meeting in Bonn. Secondarily, if I have to spend 3 weeks with him, I want somebody I can chat to.
Oh, well, I'll send over some more.
No, it does. No hurry.
When do you leave?
The end of next month.
How would you like a little trip to Switzerland in the meantime?
Not a lot.
No? Why not?
I find Switzerland a dreary country.
Oh, yes, yes, I agree. The only thing that seems to animate them is money.
Well, the Bible tells us that we shouldn't build our houses on sand. The Swiss have built an entire nation on snow. They have to be interested in money in case they have a hot winter.
You don't ski?
Heavens forfend.
What would you say if you were to meet a Swiss banker who wanted to undermine the whole concept of modern finance?
Well, I should say, stick a pin through his middle and have him mounted on a small black frame. You would have a collector's item.
Would you be interested in bidding for such an item?
Just because we're at a party, Fowler, we don't have to play party games.
Cindy, did you know about the Big Dipper at Coney Island? It is so big that when you get your ticket, they sell you travel.
What's it all about?
Hmm? Oh, just something I have in mind.
Does Caswell know?
He's away. He's not very well, I'm afraid.
I know.
No, it's just something that's come up. Would you like to take a mug of coffee with me tomorrow morning?
Possibly.
Say 11.
All right. Well, if I can't make a mug of coffee at 11, then perhaps we might take a dish of tea at 4.
Sorry I was late.
Oh, you didn't miss much. How did you enjoy the pictures?
Well, they weren't pictures, actually.
Well, sculptures, then.
Machines.
What do you mean, like combine harvesters?
Computers.
Good God, you're not going to cover the walls with those now, are you?
It was an exhibition of cybernetics.
Really? How would you like a trip to Switzerland?
Well, you know I would. When?
I don't know. It's an idea of Jason Fowler's. I'm going to speak to him about it tomorrow morning. I thought cybernetics was one of Lincoln Dowling's provinces.
Yes, he took me.
Oh.
Well, you wouldn't have wanted to take me now, would you? You can take me to Switzerland.
What are you up to, Fowler?
Up to, my dear fellow?
Up to, Jayston.
Do you take sugar?
Yes, please.
Did you know that between them, South Africa and Russia control 30% of the world's free gold?
Yes.
That's rather a disturbing thought, don't you find?
No.
No? Well, most people do.
I haven't noticed my wife's cleaning woman getting hysterical over the idea.
Well, most people are concerned with the problem. How is your wife, by the way?
Oh, come to the point, Jayston.
I read the most interesting article by a Swiss banker. Well, actually, I had a talk with him when he was over in London some weeks ago. He seemed to me to have got the measure of it.
For what?
Well, he made the point that in all probability, the world would divide itself up into two nations. white on the one hand, and colored, that is to say, Negro, Chinese, Indian, and the rest, on the other. South Africa would almost certainly be taken over by the colored races, together with its gold.
And that would put the Russians, who are white, in our camp, together with their gold.
Unless, of course, the colored races were aligned to communist China.
Not a dependable hypothesis.
Herr Wisselmann.
Who?
This Swiss banker fellow. He made the point that if we don't move away from gold during the next 50 years, we could find our financial system at the mercy of intolerable blackmail.
And what does he suggest?
Well, he has several ideas. One of them being paper gold.
I thought we already had that, represented in the floating rate of exchange.
Ah, but he wants to take these ideas further. But it's the principle he's putting forward that is most interesting. You see, the financial structure of the Western world is in a shambles and likely to get worse. Everyone is trying to find a way through. Now, here is a man who's coming forward with some original and unorthodox thinking. Well, don't you think that's interesting?
Fascinating. Well, thank you for the coffee, Jayston.
You're going?
I can't quite see what else you want me for.
But I hadn't finished.
Oh.
There's to be a conference. Well, more of a seminar, really, to be held in Geneva next week under the unofficial auspices of the World Bank.
And you thought that I might like to go there? Why?
I didn't assume you'd want to go at all, Wilder. I thought perhaps you might be concerned to do something for the department. Herr Wisselmann was to have addressed this seminar on the subject we've been talking about, but I now learn he isn't.
So?
Well, I suppose pressure's been brought to bear on him. Possibly by the Swiss themselves, who hate him because they think he's a renegade. Possibly by the French, by the Germans, or even the Americans.
Why are these great nations lowering over this tiny gnome from Zurich?
Well, because it's just the sort of thing the press might seize on and make much of.
Oh, why shouldn't we want them to make much of it?
Because there has to be a change in the financial structure. I, together with my colleagues in foreign governments, have been asked to put our views forward. Now, we know what might happen. We don't know what will happen. A little publicity might drive these other nations out into the open, which is healthy.
And you want me to go and persuade this economic Martin Luther to stand up and be counted?
Well, I think it'd be a good thing if he did speak on the subject. No, I wondered whether you would like to take on the combined might of the French, Swiss, Germans, and Americans. Would you?
No. Thank you for the coffee, Jayston. Oh, and by the way, that other interpreter you sent me was as dreary as the rest, and he also had adenoids. Have them take a medical first, would you?
West Germany. I like West
Germany.
Very much.
Hope you live to see it.
How long shall we be there for, Sir John?
How many languages do you actually speak?
French, Italian, and German.
Do you cough in all these languages?
Bronchitis.
Well, when you come to think of it, there may be a clue here. Why did you ask how long we'd be there?
Well, the hospital have allocated me a bed towards the end of next month. Of course, it doesn't matter. I mean, I can always...
Accept it. Accept it, Mr. Hamilton.
But I am private, Sir John. They'll find me...
Thank you. Thank you. Sir Jayston will be in touch with you. Thank you very much for coming. Since your time is much more valuable than mine. Don?
You called, Master?
Take a memo to Jayston Fowler, will you?
You're saying what?
Quote, government, even in its best state, is but a necessary evil. In its worst state, an intolerable one, unquote.
Tom Paine.
You are well read.
What's Fowler done now?
Why, he'd imagine that I should want to spend 3 weeks with a man I wouldn't even take a cup of coffee with in a Brighton snack bar, I can't imagine.
Well, there's a shorter Tom Paine quotation, if you prefer to use it.
What's that?
These are the times that try men's souls.
No. Just bring him and tell him I'll make my own arrangements.
There's a another interpreter here to see you, Sir John.
We never know. Maybe Mr. Wright.
All right, I'll see him. Show him in, Mrs. Waters, will you?
Do you know what you're looking for, John?
I won't know till I see it.
Oh, maybe you've just seen it.
Sir John Wilder?
Oh, this is Sir John Wilder. I'm the man who thought the next breakthrough would be in colour radio. Who's that?
You may well ask, Mr. Henderson. I gather Sir Jason sent her over as a last resort.
Well, as a last resort, I wouldn't mind resorting to.
Oh, my father's Lord Wessex.
Ah, I thought sex would be in it somewhere.
Well, shall we sit down?
Okay. Are you nervous?
Of course I'm not nervous.
Okay, don't snap my head off. Everyone gets nervous at interviews.
Well, I assure you that I'm not in the least.
Fine. Bit pompous, isn't it? I assure you I'm not in the least. You sound like my father.
How old are you?
20. How old are you?
Has that any bearing on it?
Where's mine? Jayston told me you wanted an interpreter. I can speak four languages, so it wouldn't really matter if I was 85, would it?
Do you want this job? Well, then, if you're not keen, I suggest we... No.
Okay.
Sit down a minute. How many languages do you actually speak?
French, German, Russian, Italian. Very uptight, aren't you?
What does that mean?
Well, sort of... Well, it's only a job, isn't it? You might as well try and get some fun out of it.
Is that what you think?
Sure. You see them all the time.
See what?
People who go about their jobs as if they were in prison. They seem to think their good time is coming when they retire. But they forget. They're going to be so old. Well, it's like being good all your life because you'll get your reward in heaven. If there's no heaven, you've been swindled. See? You're not so uptight now.
No. Do you really want this job?
Sure.
Why?
I need the money. I'd like to go to Bonn. And Jayston thought I might get a bit of skiing.
Do they ski in Bonn?
Well, Jayston seemed to think we might be going to Switzerland for 2 or 3 days first.
How did he? All right. The job's yours. I can't guarantee the skiing. What's your name?
Perpetua.
Oh, good God.
Isn't it a dog? My father chose it. He's hooked on history, and it's the name of a 3rd century virgin martyr.
Really? A fate that is hardly liable to overtake you, I should think.
Oh, no. I'm not going to be anyone's martyr. I'm on the pill.
You said quite definitely that if you went at all, we'd both go.
Well, it just turns out that it isn't possible. It'll be all business. I shan't have any spare time at all.
I bought all these things.
Well, you can wear them when we go down to visit Tony and Sewell.
Après-ski in Weymouth?
I'm sorry, but there you are.
You know what you are, don't you, John? You're a...
But I've made arrangements to go with you.
Well, it turns out that I shan't be needing you. Why do I have to explain everything twice to everybody?
Jayston told me I could assume I would be.
That might teach you not to arrange your life around the assumptions of Jayston Fowler. It's likely that I might have to handle this in a quite unorthodox way. And I don't want the full might and pomposity of the Foreign Office breathing down my neck. I shall take Don with me.
I see.
There's no need to be so uptight about it.
Up what?
Upset.
I'm not in the least upset. I shall simply have to rearrange things, that's all. Yes, well, you don't appear to be figuring very prominently amongst this week's most popular people.
Well, he's probably annoyed that he won't get any skiing.
Are you going for the skiing?
I don't ski. Oh, Don, do something for me, will you? Find out all you can about Herr Wisselmann.
Wattleman?
Wisselmann. He's a banker from Zurich. Wisselmann Gesellschaft.
Yeah, I'll see what I can do. There's not much you can learn about the Swiss. They get born, they die. Nothing much seems to happen in between, except they grow richer.
Well, I'll see what you can do and arrange a meeting for me with him next weekend.
All right, shall I book the air tickets?
Yeah, if you would.
How many?
Well, one. Only yours. I shall take the Rose. I shall take it gently down there and you can fly out on Friday.
Oh, you and Pamela are taking a bit of a holiday, are you?
Yeah. Oh, no. Pamela is not coming.
Well, she said she was.
Yes, well, it's, it'd be, with one thing and another.
Oh, and you're going to sit by yourself in the back of a Rolls all the way to Geneva?
No, I shall probably take the interpreter with me.
Oh, I see. And that's your idea of taking it gently, is it?
Well, I can't stand here yapping about it. You make your own arrangements, will you? And I'll make mine.
Are you all right, Sir John?
You know, John, you go on like this, and you find yourself overdrawn at the blood bank.
Master's monastic cell.
Hello, Armiton. What are you doing around here?
My master's upstairs taking tea with the great Bligh. A somewhat immovable feast, so I dropped in for a gossip. While they haggle over who's to have the chocolate biscuit.
Have you any gossip?
My dear, I wish I had. I hear the off-white knight has taken to the road again. Tilting at windmills.
Is that what they call him?
It's quite nice, isn't it? Jay Wilder, the off-white knight. My own.
It's very good.
What do you call Lord Bligh?
Well, being directly over us, we call him the Lord Above.
That's nice. Is it true the knight took a dolly girl with him?
Where did you hear that?
It was murmured at me in a discotheque by a depraved adolescent, friend of the aforesaid dolly of the first part.
I had no idea.
How dull you've become! It's your devotion to affairs of state.
What affairs are you devoting yourself to?
My dear, if I could only speak. So you sit here, do you, doing your good works while your master is paddling in the pool of permissive society, down at the shallow end where the children play.
What have you heard?
I think you'll find that these days even to venture in the shallow end puts you in over your head. Well, she's only 20, but the poor man could drown.
Who is she?
Perpetua Cataline, Lord Wessex's wayward youngest. Cheltenham Ladies' College, a brief but startling term in Zurich. Sussex University, Grosvenor Square riots, reads Queen, Nova, and the Black Dwarf, smokes pot, takes the pill, intends refusing to vote, and the King's Road passes straight through her flat. In short, the product Emily Pankhurst gave her entire life to allow its head.
My God.
Well, may you call on your deity. I hope Sir John is. Well, there you are, my dear. I've given you my gossip. Have you none to give me?
None at all.
Oh, dear.
Lady Wilder is on the phone for you, Mr. Dowling.
You lie to me, Lincoln.
Connecting doors. Did you stipulate that?
I didn't actually ask you, no.
Sir, can I order a drink?
Of course.
Well, I thought I ought to ask nicely. It's a bit like being out with Daddy.
Look, I didn't specifically ask for connecting doors.
Okay. Go and have your bath. Do you want a drink?
All right. I'll have a scotch. If you can manage it.
Don't get so screwed up, baby. Is it supposed to be a secret from me why you're doing all this?
Can I
give you a lift.
Oh, thank you.
Tell me, is it true that Wilder took Perpetua Catiline to Geneva with
it? It is. I understood it was you who sent it to see him.
Yes, it was. Yes, I got tired of him sending back every interpreter that I suggested. And I thought the sight of her mini-skirted thighs would bring him out in a hot sweat.
I gather they did. And make Switzerland a little more inviting.
Well, I did feel that was a bit naughty of me. But you see, I imagined he'd be travelling with a party of you, and that with you there to keep an eye on him, her inaccessibility would drive him mad.
He seems to have spiked your guns.
Yes. She's a very pretty girl.
Very. And sexy.
Extremely. Do you think she,
Oh, I wouldn't be surprised.
No. You know, Lincoln, much as I disapprove of Wilder, oh, there are times when I could wish I were he. Are you ready?
Hey, where are you? I need zipping up.
I will be a minute.
Merci.
Je vous en prie.
Ah. Dinner.
So we're eating here, I take it.
You don't mind?
Well, I don't mind where I eat as long as I don't have to pay for it. There's dancing downstairs in the restaurant.
I don't dance.
No, but I do.
Well, we might try it later on.
Tell me, did you see a lot of Ronald Coleman movies when you were young?
What time did you get in last night? Or should I say this morning?
Oh, God, it is going to be like being out with Daddy.
All right, let's go, Goodall.
Is Sir John at the hotel?
No, sir. I have a message for you. Sir John Wilder is spending the weekend at St. Moritz. He will not be arriving until Monday.
Oh, blimey.
Why not?
Well...
Look, we take the train to Poole, we pick up the boat, sail it down to Salcombe, stay the night with these friends of mine, and catch the train back on Sunday. It's perfectly respectable.
Oh, I didn't think for a minute it wouldn't.
Then what?
Oh, I...
Look, if you're worried, no one need ever know.
I don't think I want to do things anymore that people don't have to know about.
All right. Just seemed a pleasant way of spending the weekend.
Yes, because I'm sure it would be. Did you know that I had an affair a couple of years ago?
No.
I just wondered if it might be in one of those dossiers government departments are so fond of drawing up nowadays.
Tell me about it.
Well, did it because of John, really? I think I said to myself, if he can do so and so, I can do such and such, and the hell with it. Oh, it wasn't much of an affair, really, looking back on it. I mean, there was never really any chance of my going away with him. I wasn't prepared to give up what I'd got. So it was rather sneaky, really. Don't you think?
I don't believe you.
All right.
I think you probably did love him.
He was just an implement.
What does that mean?
I'm just telling you what happened.
I don't care what you're not prepared to give up.
Lincoln, you're a bloody fool.
All right. Let's just take it I might be. I'm sure I'm not the only one about.
Well, at least you're a trier.
Mm.
Shall I tell you how to do the dances these days?
How, except by losing two souls?
You do them as if you wanted to do them. Just let yourself go. The thing about dancing now is that if you're enjoying it, you're doing it right. You're too aware of yourself.
Well, thanks for the advice.
No trouble. Let go a little, baby.
Do you have to call me baby?
Oh, come on. You're not the great John Wilder here. You're just some cat out dancing with a bird.
I don't even understand the language.
Cat is you, bird is me.
Does the cat get the bird?
That's better.
Really?
You're too much.
What does that mean?
It means you grab me where I live. I like you.
I couldn't get any reply.
Well, I expect they thought we wouldn't get this far in this kind of weather.
Probably. Anyway, we're stuck here for the night. It's 20 miles to Salcombe.
Where are we?
Brixham. I suppose I'd better go and find a hotel.
Why?
Well, the only two bunks there are in here.
What are you trying to tell me? That you snow?
When I was 18, there was this guy in Zurich. He was about 30. He taught me pretty well all I know about men. And he never touched me. Hey, and you know what? When he got married, he named his first kid after me. Isn't that fantastic? I think all girls look for is a father figure to lean against. Young girls. I suppose it's a way of saying they really did love their father. Fathers are usually such failures. Mine is.
Difficult to explain. When it was all over and the pieces put together again, I said to myself, never no more. Never. Never no more. And if I did, after saying that to myself, I don't think I'd be able to trust anything I thought ever again. Different now. Things have changed. For better.
better as things ever are. John's changed too. Seems to need me more. So, I'm sorry.
Good night.
You're a funny person.
Why?
So neat. Neat shirt, neat suit, neatly tied tie. Neat watch strap. It's as if you thought it was possible to tidy up the whole of life and make some order out of it.
Now, isn't it?
You have delivered as it comes. You didn't give me this job just because I speak four languages.
No, not entirely.
No, I knew that first day in your office.
Why did you come?
Because the grave's a fine and private place, but none, I think, do their embrace.
Who wrote that?
Andrew Marvel. Mm-hmm. Solid sender, if there ever was one. But at my back, I always hear time's winged chariot hurrying near, and yonder, all before us, lie deserts of vast eternity.
If we had world enough and time, this coyness lady were no crime.
Hey, man! That's out of sight. Underneath the neat shirt, there's a poet.
My love is of a birth as rare as 'tis of objects strange and high. It was begotten by despair upon impossibility.
Nothing's impossible, baby. Hey, look at the time. Bed?
John, look, we've been looking everywhere for you. Yes. This is Herr Wisselmann.
How do you do? Tomorrow, Don.
Well, Herr Wisselmann wanted to meet you to have a chat.
Yes, well, first thing tomorrow, Don, if you'll excuse us. Yes.
Yeah, but John. Oh, I'm sorry.
Not at all. There are, thank God, still some things equally important as money. Of course, as a banker, I always ask myself, how much costs such a thing?
Are you, Bart?
Good morning, Don.
Yes. So it would seem. That's a bit strong, isn't it?
What is?
Hi, man.
Oh, hello.
What did you want me for, Don?
Hmm? I wondered if you felt more inclined
How old would you say I was? I mean, if you didn't know me and you met me in a bar, what age would you put me at?
Well, this morning? Oh, say about 83, give or take a year or two.
I mean, if you saw me in a bar, say, with that girl, and I said I was 49, what would you think?
Oh, come now, John. 49 is young for a dirty old man.
I thought you were supposed to stay in Geneva till I got there.
Look, I've got Herr Wisselmann downstairs.
Hello, tomorrow morning.
John, you said this morning he's come all the way from Geneva, and I promised him faithfully.
Ready?
Wait a while downstairs. I might have to see somebody. It won't take more than half an hour. Just wait for me.
You're crazy. I'm not sitting around in the snow waiting for you. I might get my backside frozen off, and I need it.
Now, look, just wait for me downstairs. I won't be more than half an hour.
Cool it, baby. Cool it. You're coming unglued. You do what you have to do. No fuss. I can go up with that dolly instructor. Ciao.
Perpetua?
Perpetua?
Look, Don, Find Herr Wissler.
John!
Find out.
John!
Tonight will do.
Don't be a bloody fool. Anyway, you know it'll take more than half an hour.
You reckon so?
And you don't ski, remember? John, look...
When in Rome...
Yes, well, take it gently, will you? Now, you're overdoing things. You know what it is that sits at the bottom of the sea and shakes?
What?
A nervous wreck.
All right, I'll see him now. Right. Oh, Don, tell that girl that the skiing is off. I want her to interpret.
But he speaks English.
Don, just go and tell her.
All right, all right. But, John, you can't keep a girl of her age away from all the dolly young men in the world. Not at your age.
You get them?
Yes.
Happy ending.
They'll take the boat on so we can catch the train back if we want to.
Well, that's that. I shall miss this boat.
We don't have to catch the train if we don't want to.
I think we should. There aren't those many trains on a Sunday morning. I hope you weren't too disappointed with your trip.
Of course not. It was, as I said it would be, a pleasant way of spending the weekend.
I've still got some washing up to do.
Will you tell him how you spend the weekend?
Probably not. Well, there isn't very much to tell, is there? Only if it comes up, and it probably won't.
Ahoy! Hey, you out of bed yet? Hello, old chap. We thought you'd gone amok on Start Point. Oh, hello.
Oh, darling, we imagined you feeding fishies.
Oh, I can't even get into these flies.
Steady the old sea legs. This is a friend of ours staying with us.
Pamela, darling, what are you doing here? And Lincoln, darling.
You know each other? Oh, isn't that wonderful?
Great. You have no idea how I was dreading this train journey back. It takes hours. I was overjoyed when I saw it was you two. Was the train crowded coming down? Oh, but of course you came by boat. I expect that was a bit crowded too, wasn't it? Still, that could be quite pleasant. Who steered?
Aunt May. Yes, marvellous navigator. Actually, it was a bit crowded, but I managed to squeeze into the after cabin, and May and Pamela had the main cabin. May had to go over to Torquay first thing this morning, or you'd have met her. I don't know where we'd have been without her in that storm. She's an incredible woman for her age.
What is her age?
69. She's unbelievably good at splicing ropes and spiking guns. That's an old nautical term.
Yes, I had heard the phrase.
You come all the way from England to try to persuade me to do something which I had never had any intention of doing anyway.
You didn't intend to speak?
Oh, I shall address them, yes. But I have not yet decided upon what subject I shall address them.
You mean other interests have perhaps persuaded you?
Oh, there has been no pressure put upon me whatsoever, of any kind, by anyone.
Oh, from the Americans?
No.
Or the French?
None at all.
From your own country?
Here I am regarded as eccentric.
And why did you change your mind?
I haven't changed my mind. Sir John, you have seen an article of mine in which I put forward the two nations hypothesis and the idea of paper gold. But it was only an hypothesis, an amusing idea. It's not even wholly true. Gold is fairly evenly distributed over the whole world. If it is on the land, it is probably also under the sea. If we need it enough, we can always find it.
That is also my idea.
Oh, may I? You know what magazine I wrote it for?
No.
It was for Ampersand.
Well, it's a Swiss satirical magazine.
Oh, the basis of the article is quite feasible. The idea is possible. It is just that it is not immediately probable. I think you are the only ones who have taken it seriously.
Collapse of Stout Party.
Where did you read the article, Sir John?
I haven't read it, as a matter of fact.
You were told about it. May I ask by whom?
By a colleague of mine.
Would I know him?
His name is Jayston Fowler.
Ah, Herr Fowler. He and I have had a long and interesting discussion upon the subject when I was in London last month. I I think I have made the mistake of thinking that that discussion was also hypothetical. I'm afraid nobody appreciates my sense of humor.
What do you mean by that?
Well, I understand your Sir Jayston Fowler has to put in a report on the reorganization of international currencies.
He gave me a long and boring lecture about it.
I expect he was trying it on the dog. He struck me as a man who needed an idea. Perhaps because for years an idea has been expected of him and he has never been able to deliver. I suppose it would be a great help to him to be able to quote from something as respectable as a conference of the World Bank.
Herr Wissermann, if you are looking for a subject for your lecture, how about the manipulation of ideas by government officials for their own ends?
Now, that is a good idea. And now, if you will excuse me, since I am here, I think I will try and recapture some of my lost youth on the nursery slopes. It has been very nice meeting you. Es hat mich sehr erfreut.
Auf Wiedersehen.
Herr Wissermann.
Thank you.
Nice fella. Are you going to listen to his speech?
What for? Fowler only asked me to persuade him to talk. He didn't say on what subject.
I thought he was dishy. Pretty nearly the greatest thing since sliced bread.
Oh, come along, Perpetua, baby. Get your slide area off that sofa and zip it into your ski pants. There's no snow in the King's Road, booby baby.
Get him.
You know, suddenly, I think you're getting on the ball again, Jackson. Thank God she got out at Reading.
Yeah, I was terrified she'd invite us up for drinks. Lincoln.
Yes?
Who did John go to Switzerland with?
With? Well, he took Henderson with him.
Nobody else?
I really don't know. Why?
Well, I just thought it was odd that he didn't want you to go with him. Or me.
I've no idea.
Good for you. Are we there?
It's just about. Would you like to come to my place first for a drink?
Oh, I think I'd better get back. Thanks for a super weekend and everything.
Nonsense. I'm going to Cheltenham tomorrow for the day. I don't suppose you'd like to come.
I think...
Think about it. We can always take Aunt May with us. Yeah, well, I'll see you in London the day after tomorrow.
Are you all leaving today?
Yes, I'm catching a plane this afternoon. Taking a few little gifts home with you, are you?
We bought some little things. When she knew that my ambassador status gave me customs immunity, there was no stopping her.
Yes, well, all the most desirable properties cost the earth these days. You know, you're looking tired, John.
Well, this is the altitude.
Oh, you think so?
Well, have you tried doing the Watutsi, or whatever it's called, 3 nights in a row?
I haven't tried doing it 3 minutes in a row.
I'll tell you something, Don, which is quite true, that a man is as young as he feels, and I feel like death.
Or perhaps you're a little overdrawn at the fun bank.
Hey, John, if we got Goodall to drive like hell, we could stop the night at that place that had that discotheque, huh?
We'll see. Look. Try taking it easy, will you? You know what they say. Death is nature's way of telling you to slow down.
Give me a ring, huh?
Okay.
Okay. Only not next week. Next week I'm in a demonstration for war on want.
As long as you know what you want. What the hell are they?
Do you really think we will get all that stuff through without paying duty?
My dear child, I've told you I have diplomatic immunity.
Oh, God, don't start getting pompous again just because we're back in England.
Good day, sir. I have to ask you if you're familiar with this document.
I have read it.
Perhaps you both just step outside and stand beside the car, sir.
I think you'll find I have diplomatic immunity.
You'd just wait a moment, sir.
Now what?
Don't panic.
Good day, Sir John. Madam.
Good day. Is everything all right?
Perfectly, sir.
Splendid.
But we would be very grateful if you would step outside and stand beside your car, sir.
I'm on Her Majesty's diplomatic service.
Oh, yes, sir.
Well, then, what's all this about?
If you would just step outside, sir, perhaps we could explain.
I'm damned if I will. Look, fetch somebody with more authority, your superior.
I'm afraid there's no one here with more authority, sir. I'm sorry, sir, but I must insist.
You mean you're not prepared to take that on its face value?
Oh, we take nothing on face value, sir. After all, for all we know, the young lady could be an underage, unfrocked nun. Couldn't she, sir?
Don! Look, Don, get hold of Fowler. Get hold of Fowler this minute. I can't find him.
Well, what's wrong? Oh, Lord.
Yes, yes, right away.
He's claiming what? Oh, well, I'm afraid he can't do that. No, you see, he isn't actually accredited. Well, not to any particular country, you see. Well, I'm terribly sorry, but I'm afraid that's his problem.
Look, John, I've got hold of Fowler, but,
He said what? Oh, all right, Don. All right. I'll see Fowler when I get back to London.
Well, Sir John, you'll be pleased to hear we haven't found anything other than the things in the boot.
No? Well, let me tell you something that you'll be less pleased to hear. I could have told you that without all this officious nonsense. And if this is the gateway to England, the country would be far better off if they put you back in your laboratory jar in which you've obviously spent half your life.
We get a great many diplomats through here, Sir John. If they all paid their duty, perhaps the country would be able to afford the formaldehyde.
All right. Put the bloody thing back together again.
I'm afraid not, sir. Although we have the right to take the car apart if we think it necessary, it is not incumbent on us to have to reassemble it again. Thank you, sir.
Oh, baby. That customs immunity. I don't think the vaccine took.
These things are yours, I think. You bought them. You pay the duty.
Baby.
And Goodall. Give her a spanner.